So when we talk about monitoring, monitoring has different meaning at different levels. Suppose a head of Asia region of an international agency sitting there and monitoring budgets. What would he monitor? A large donor agency funding 150 projects in South Asia. He's doing budget monitoring. What will he monitor? For him or her, he will see what was allocated. How much was total, okay, let's say $1 million to support 100 projects, right? So he will see, okay, $1 million was there and whether 100 projects were supported, and in this amount was given, total so much. He will not go into what happened every month in your project, right? Come one level down. Under that head of the South Asia region, there are various program officers, right? So each program officer has got 10 NGOs to monitor. What level they will monitor? They will see each project, but broadly, annually, how much they have spent, whether it is within, in line with the, with your projected budget, and actually what you have spent and so on, right? Come down to the chief executive level, chief functionary of the organization. Now we'll go a bit more micro. You look at each project head-wise, how much, which activities we are doing, which we are not doing, and so on. Come down to the program manager. You will see exactly, you know, each month with this was done, not done. Even go down to the grassroots level supervisor or worker, you will see each project, each activity, whether it was implemented or not implemented. So monitoring is a myth in terms of understanding it like one issue. Monitoring means different things at different levels, right? Like, for example, we monitor 170 projects in South Asia on behalf of an international donor with about 18 million euros or something like that. So there are people who handle 30 projects each. So they will look at each project wise. But when we when we sit together to look at the larger picture, we'll see what was the cash flow plan, whether it was achieved or not, individual project wise, whether they are doing well or not. If I cannot go down, or even if it, when it goes to the international office, it will not, they will not look at even individual projects also. So therefore, monitoring has to be understood in that context, right? So in our context, when we are looking at monitoring, we are looking at micro monitoring, because we are looking at what activities were planned and what was achieved. So so therefore, what was proposed? What was the project proposal? And what was the narrative to the proposed budget? What was agreed upon in the grant agreement and the MOU that we have signed up? Because you remember in the morning we talked about restricted grant? Yeah. So these are restricted grants. And if they are not restricted grants, then there are some income which the organization has earned, which also should be monitored, because at least institutionally within the organization, we have also prepared a budget of how we'll utilize it, right? So therefore, either way it needs to be monitored. So understanding the budget is very important. Budget heads and subheads. I was showing you about, you know, those 10 teachers and then 8 teachers. 10 teachers, 800, and 8 teachers, 1,000. So basically we need to understand that budget monitoring means even activities which were planned to be implemented within that budget, you know, and even tracking the budget on the basis of planned activities. And so when once we have the budget, if you have made a monthly budget, then you know exactly how much will be spent on a monthly basis. Then what you do is that you put actual expenditure. That could be also a tracking sheet for you, for the organization, right? So you have the budget, and then actual expenditure incurred so much. So therefore, you can see where you are going, whether the activity was in, was held or not held, and how much was spent, and so on. So budget, planned activities, budgeted expenditure, actual activities, and actual expenditure. And then, of course, the budgetary control towards the end, when we look at the comparison to actuals with the budgeted figures, and the corrective actions need to be taken on deviations, extension of project, budget revision, etc. can be done. So one of the things that that we need to remember in budget is that there is always an understanding that the actually what will be spent may not be exactly what was planned. So some donors allow variances, you know, up to 10% you can, in within the budget heads you can go for variations. Some donors say 20%, but it all depends, you know, from donor condition to donor conditions. And please understand also that the if a variation between what was projected and it was spent, it is not that you have failed. It just says that you are human. So nobody is expecting you to match pie to pie. Let's look at budget monitoring. The difference is minimal or difference is large. So if it might be very little excess payment or short receipts. So difference is large because of two reasons. Could be if the payment has been more, or the grant has been received less, or less payment or excess receipt. So either way, there have been large differences. So in type 1 difference, which is minimal difference, then you have by and large achieved your target or budget. In case of type 2, it is overspent or income has been less. So this type of situation requires corrective steps, and those that can be to reduce expenses in same item or other items, to increase resources to meet expenses, or to redo the budget. Initial projections might be wrong, or extra resources to reduce expenses in other items. So there are various ways of dealing with it. If there are large variances, then obviously we need to see what went wrong. If there is marginal variances, one can 5%, 10%, one can accept. Now it's very important to add notes to the variance report to explain the differences and action taken. So if there was a variance, there must be a reason for that variance, and that reason needs to be given.